The first aspect or use of meditation can be for tuning. Realigning our frequency and controlling the signals we as energy systems transmit, working with breath techniques, sonic waves and white light energy or violet light energy allows us to A. De-stress naturally and easily. B. Increase or create feelings of deep inner peace and tranquility. C. Increase the light quotient within our being and our energy fields, and thus control how the universe responds to us. D. Cleanse all cellular memory of dross, pollutants, negative emotions. Next, it can heal cellular structure via adding techniques of creative visualization, which also allow us to realign and cleanse our emotional bodies and rebalance any emotional baggage. Meditation can also regenerate cells and create more vibrant and radiant health, as well as creating an electromagnetic shield of sensitivity or selectivity around our being. It also allows us to work with our energy centers, our chakras, so that we can do things like bilocate, dematerialize, communicate telepathically within all sorts of levels within the matrix as we explore this matrix of creation. If you have unlimited time each day for meditation, then all applications 1 to 7 can be applied and practiced as desired. However, if you only have 15 to 30 minutes in the morning, then tuning techniques may be used differently to achieve different things. Generally, these days, I like just the love breath meditation. I like to keep it simple. Although the things and the meditations that we will offer in this series can be applied to bring you into a state of such clarity and clearness within your energy fields that the love breath meditation can work more powerfully. The second use of meditation, as discussed, is for opening us up to our inner guidance. And as we all know, we all hold the perfect teacher or guru within, and it is its voice that we need to listen to bring our lives into a state of magical existence. The best way to open up to the inner guidance is through being silent and tuning ourselves via our breath, perhaps using some mantras and also working with light energy, and also asking. Since we have free will, no guidance will be given unless it is requested, and this is universal law. As Jesus said, "Ask and you shall receive." And once we have stilled our minds by tuning with the breath, we can then ask for guidance, but we must learn to listen. It has always been an aspect of Western society for people to seek answers outside of themselves, to look to parents, peers, churches or governments to dictate how we would live our lives. However, if we accept the premise that no one knows us like we do, and that we hold in cellular memory all the answers to all our questions, and that we are part of a vastly loving, wise, intelligent field or matrix, then it is beneficial for us to go within and open up to answers from within the matrix within that is connected to the greater field, as many are now understanding within the metaphysical reality, we are all connected in the web of one, this vastly loving matrix that flows through all. So if life is not currently fulfilling our every expectation, then exploration of the inner realms can be most beneficial. I have always held the vision of a lost child, which is the ego or personality that we have in physical form. Caught in the wonderment of the world, which is life on earth, who one day wishes to go home, which is the reunification with the divine being within. But this child can't remember the way. A lost child wanting to go home, forgetting how. The parent, which is our divine self within the I Am Presence or Monad, has been watching, knowing that the child needed to explore and knowing that it could not offer assistance until the child acknowledged being lost and then asked for help. But when the child does this, it is a great joy for the parent who, with other loved ones, such as guides or guardian angels, prepares a wondrous welcome home party and gives as much attention and aid as is accepted by the child until it is safely home again, in other words, fully awakened to the oneness of creation. Under the heading of inner guidance also comes prayer and also even sometimes begging, as we often seem to do more in our desperate times. Seeking inner guidance is learning to ask, being still, and listening for inner guidance from this divine force within. Guidance from guides and telepathic communication employs the same techniques and is covered in detail in our book In Resonance on the chapter on telepathic communication. 3. The third aspect of meditation is being able to deprogram and reprogram. The most valuable part of our meditation contemplation time is that it allows us to play and erase inner tapes that are creating constriction and limitation in our life. It allows us to create a new reality, for we have entered into a time where the universe is serving us as we remember ourselves as the masters we are. I find it very interesting and share this often with others that sometimes it's like human beings pray to God and say, I don't like what's happening in the world, and if there is a God, why is there poverty? Why are children suffering? Why is there violence and war? And I say that it's like, I can imagine anyway, this divine force hears these words from the human race and looks at us and says, but you were made in my image. You have the creative power. You have created this through free will. And if you don't like what you have created, then create something different. In this matrix, for all the negatives, all the problems we have, as Max Planck, the founder of quantum physics, once said, there is solutions as well, but it is our creation. So we can use meditation to honestly look at our lives and look at the limitations that we have created personally and globally, and then choose to reprogram ourselves into new realities by being limitless in our thought patterns and dreaming the highest paradigms we can imagine. So this part of meditation is also a time for using affirmations and mind mastery and freeing ourselves from limited beliefs, reprogramming the new reality we wish to create as we access higher vision and also programs of destiny. Having understood the power of our thoughts plus spending time in contemplation where we assess all habitual patterns of thought and action will allow us time to rewrite and input new programs to our conscious and subconscious memory databases, and we will do detailed meditations on this in this series. All we need to do is find a quiet place where we will be not interrupted, take the phone off the hook, tune ourselves and sit and think, looking at all aspects of our life, assessing them one by one, and having pen and paper handy to make a list. We can start with the physical body, for example. Let us, in a detached way, honestly look at our physical being. What can we change? How would we like it to be? Are our dietary habits positive and life-sustaining? Is our dietary intake merely habitual? Are there better choices we can make that are less harmful to ourselves, to the planet, to animal life? Such as a vegetarian diet. Remember that unless we are masters of transmutation, meat keeps our vibration very dense, and it is possible for human beings to exist on prana alone, as is covered in some of our other written material.